All too often, speculating about alien civilizations is tied directly to the only civilization that we have so far observed, our own. We literally work from a sampling of one, and until we detect another civilization, that won't change, no matter how anthropocentric and uncertain it might seem. After all, we are human, and anyone we might detect out there would not even be remotely human. But they may still have certain similarities. One of these might be convergent evolution, a topic I'll save for a future video, but in short, they may bear some biological similarities to us simply because certain physical attributes are useful in nature and may occur independently wherever evolution does. There's a reason sharks and dolphins are similarly shaped, yet only distantly related. But another probable commonality would be a command of science, mathematics, and engineering. The reason for this is that an alien civilization that doesn't have a decent command of science and technology would probably be undetectable at a distance. We might see their planet, an exoplanet with an atmosphere clearly altered by life itself through photosynthesis, but like our own civilization before the advent of the modern age, such civilizations would not emit anything that could be detected in its own right as being of intelligent origin. To create technology and alter your world through civilization, or build megastructures in your star system, or build radio telescopes and transmitters, you need math and science. There is no other way to realistically pursue those things. But getting back to us, with technology comes danger. There is a very real possibility that we could destroy ourselves and cause our own extinction. This may also hold true for alien civilizations. To make things worse, there are several ways we could cause our own extinction. And while to our credit we have yet to do that, it remains an open possibility that we may yet do so. As such, that same possibility must be considered for other civilizations in the universe. Often, in the comments section, I see ideas where aliens would somehow be more enlightened or more intelligent than we are, and would never destroy themselves. But the truth is, we have no idea if that's true, and for all we know, civilization self-destruction is the rule of the universe. And that leads us to a possible solution to the Fermi paradox, that any flirtation with advanced technology always brings the risk, or perhaps the certainty, of extinction. Before I start, none of these scenarios are set in stone. They are subject to variables and situations that could develop and change at any time. Escalations of events, both within human civilization and nature itself, can change these equations very rapidly, so no one scenario should be seen as likely or unlikely, just possible for us, and how those might conceivably apply to alien civilizations as well. First and foremost is the inability to gain a sufficient command of nature to mitigate natural disasters. Most natural disasters that can happen to planet Earth will not cause our extinction, just massive damage such as earthquakes and hurricanes. But this planet has seen natural disasters in the past that we, in our current state, have no chance of handling at the moment, even with our technology. This changes as time moves forward and technology advances, but there are natural disasters that can happen that would require extremely advanced technologies to avert, which we are nothing close to at this time. The most obvious would be an asteroid impact. That could end our civilization, but we're not that far from being able to detect and deflect asteroids and comets that might threaten Earth. We merely need to look for them proactively and plan on how to deflect them. Aliens would do this too. Exocomets transiting other stars have already been detected, so this is a problem that would face alien civilizations as much as it does our own. But if they survived such impacts as life on Earth has, to the point that a spacefaring civilization could arise, chances are they would be able to deflect any threats relatively quickly, unless the comet happened to hit right at the advent of space travel. But other examples of natural disasters might not be so easily avoided, and may take a civilization thousands of years of technological development to be averted. One might be the volcanism of their planet. In Earth's history, volcanism such as the Siberian Traps has gotten so bad as to cause massive levels of extinction. Controlling massive volcanism would be very difficult for all but the most advanced civilizations, but other natural problems might include a close-by gamma-ray burst sterilizing the surface of their planet, or natural climate change shifting past what they could handle. But if a civilization can make it past those types of extinction events, as we so far have, then what other dangers do they face? Chief among these is their own technology. The most obvious case here from our own civilization are nuclear weapons. While their effect on civilization depends on how large of a nuclear exchange occurs, regardless, such a thing would be catastrophic in any event. But there are more murky ways that human civilization could end through warfare, including biological weaponry. But war isn't the only possible end for a civilization. Again, with technological advance comes new dangers, such as artificial intelligence, which if mismanaged could present an unprecedented threat to a civilization in ways that are not easy to predict. And such a thing may not just present a threat to the civilization that created it, but in fact any biological civilization it wishes to exterminate if it perceives other advanced civilizations in the galaxy as threats. In short, the result could be a machine civilization that lays low until biological civilizations present a threat. It may then either destroy up-and-coming biological civilizations or downshift them to an earlier stage of development in order to maintain its galactic hegemony. While highly speculative, the lesson here would be that future technologies that we will no doubt explore could present unforeseen threats to human civilization in the future. This may also hold true for other civilizations that may have existed in the universe, and it could be that the reason we see no evidence of far-flung galactic empires, at least yet, is that the greatest filter that stands before a civilization is its own technology, and that civilizations in general only exist for a very short time. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently presenting the other side of the argument. Civilizations in the galaxy might also be very long-lived, and possibly cranky in their old age. Kids these days, you humans haven't even transcended your biological bodies. Very disconcerting, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth exploration into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.